Alrighty, my friends, guess what? There's a fly right there. It is time to cook some chicken drumsticks. These are fresh. These are Sanderson Farms chicken. This is Sanderson's farm chicken. I bought it at Priceless Foods right up the street on South John B. Dennis Highway right here in lovely Kingsport, Tennessee. I'm going to season it with none other than Tony Sachery's original Creole seasoning. And it says great on everything, and they are right. All right, we're going to open. First we want to turn our burners on. I heard that one light. I turn them all the way down to low. And we will open the grill up and throw them on there. I'll be right back. Don't go nowhere, it's the big old show. Alrighty, I just got through seasoning my chicken with Tony Sachery's Creole seasoning. Don't leave home without this stuff, people, it's great. And let me show you what I'm talking about. Look how beautiful these look. See the seasoning on the chicken? And if you, I got a little bit too much seasoning on this one right here, but when I flip it, half of it will fall off anyway, so it's no big deal. And chicken takes a lot longer than beef or pork. It takes it longer than pork, and it takes definitely a lot longer than cooking beef like hamburger steaks. So on low heat with these burners turned all the way down, it'll probably take about 25 minutes, give or take. It all depends on how, you know, my grill gets extremely hot. That's why I always cook on low heat as far as they will go. This dining glow too gets extremely hot. It's going on what kind of grill you're cooking with and what kind of temperature you can maintain. With charcoal grills, it's harder to maintain a consistent temperature. But with cooking with propane, you know, LP gas grill, it's a lot easier to maintain your temperature to control it. I say a ballpark figure, 25 minutes. After about 8 minutes, I will rotate the chicken. It's the big old show. Right here, this is Mother's Day. What is this, May the 9th? This is Sunday, May the 9th, 2021. Hope everyone out there who's a woman, or you know, a mom, whatever, no matter who you are, if you're a woman and you have children, I wish you a happy Mother's Day. It's been quite windy here in lovely Kingsport, Tennessee for the last 2 days. Good times. You got that right, my friend. Good times. See them? But it's been windy the last 2 days. Over the last hour, it's calmed down a lot. But we've been having a lot of high wind gusts over the last 2 days. It's cloudy. I think the 30% chance of rain, I think, tonight. And I think there's a good chance of scattered showers tomorrow, if I'm not mistaken. Temperature is lovely. Nice, pleasant. If I had to guess, I'd say it's probably about 72 degrees. Had to guess. Thanks for watching. I'll be back shortly. Can you smell what the big O's cooking? Now that's the real question. Temperature slowly rising. We'll get up to about 400 here in a little bit. Check back in a minute, alligators. Alrighty, my friends. After cooking the chicken on one side for about 8 minutes, I just flipped them. And when I flipped them, I put another medium coating of Tony Sachery's Creole seasoning on the chicken. We will close the lid and let them cook a little longer. Can you smell what the big O's cooking? Now that's what I'm talking about. Chicken on a grill, chicken on a grill. Close her up. Let the temperature, it was up to about 300. It'll go right back up. This thing will reach about 400. So I have to watch it. Wind's blowing again. Let's pick back up. As you can see, hear the birds. Things beautiful and green. Very, very beautiful and green. I cut my yard 2 days ago. Day and a half, yeah, 2 days ago. I'll be back shortly. Don't go nowhere, it's the big old show. The only place to go. I've got six corn out here, six ears of corn out here. And let me show you what I'm talking about. I'm going to take and shuck this corn, pull all the, you know, the leaves off of it, basically. Pull all this hairy stuff out of it. I will shuck them, that means you pull all the leaf stuff off of it. Pull the straw off of it, get it clean. And this is bicolor corn. It's like yellow and light medium yellow. Yep, cream colored yellow and kind of a medium yellow. That's why they call it bicolor. And I will take, once I shuck it, I will coat them with bluebonnet margarine, little pepper, wrap them up in aluminum foil. And when I wrap them in aluminum foil, I will place them up here on this top wire rack. And it's about another minute, it will be time to rotate these. I already rotated them twice and put the Tony Sacheries on the other side. So this is what it's all about. Corn and chicken, chicken and corn. CC, chicken and corn. It's the big old show. It's trying to rain on me. I'm going to shut the corn. And all you do, I'm going to stand here over my trash can and throw all the leaves and all the hair out of this corn into the trash can. To shuck it, all you do is reach up here and grab your leaves on the corn, whatever you want to call it. Shuck it means you just pull them away. You pull it away, throw it in the trash can. Grab some more. Throw the leaves away. Shucking my corn. Tri-color, see there? Medium yellow and light cream color. That's two different colors. That's why they call it bicolor. I said tricolor. That's why they call it bicolor. Tricolor means corn is three colors. This is bicolor. Pull it away. And I've cut my grill off temporarily because I don't want to burn my chicken. It's going to take a minute to shuck this corn. I've had it in the fridge about a week, so it's time to get it cooked. It's trying to rain on me. The wind's picked up. So, pull all this little hair stuff off of it. See here? Pull that off the corn. I'm not going to sit here and film shucking all six ears. You know, that would defeat the purpose. There's no logic in doing that. When you get it shucked, it looks like this. If there's a bad spot on it, because it's been in the fridge about a week, so if I don't get this cooked, it'll probably run in about 3 or 4 days. So if you got a bad spot on the end, just cut that off, because you don't want to wrap a bad spot in with aluminum foil. That can interfere with the flavor. So all you do is take a knife and shim that off, or cut this little piece off. Wrap it in aluminum foil, put bluebonnet margarine on it, put a little black pepper, wrap it in aluminum foil, place it on top rack on your grill. That's how you shuck corn. The big old way. Shuck that corn, baby. Shuck that corn. Now on the corn, what I do is once I shuck the corn, I take and I rinse it off real good. Run some water in the sink, rinse it off. Once I rinse the corn off, if there's a bad end, I cut it off with a knife. Then I will pat it dry with a towel. Then we will place bluebonnet margarine on the corn. And we will add a little pepper. Bluebonnet margarine pepper. And I've already pre-tore six pieces of aluminum foil. I've already pre-tore it. Torn it ahead of time, so it'll make it be a lot easier. So let me get this washed, patted dry. When I wrap the last piece of corn, I will show you all how I do it. So I'm on the last piece of corn, and after I washed it in the sink, I let it just sit here in the air dry, basically. I didn't even have to pat it down. I had pre-torn the six pieces of aluminum foil. You take the corn, put on one side of it, put bluebonnet margarine, and I use a fork, like here. Out of my bluebonnet margarine, I use a fork. I take the fork, and I spread it across one side of the corn. Then I put pepper on it. I take pepper and I do like this right here. I put pepper on it. I put a little pepper right here on the foil, so when you wrap it, that pepper will go all the way around your corn. So once you do one side, all you do is roll it over the corn on the opposite side. You don't have to put margarine all the way around the corn. Roll it over, get over in your blue bonnet margarine bowl with your fork, and we're not cooking margarine, we're cooking corn, so don't overdo it. And you just take and you spread it along this side right here and throw a little pepper on it, and you wrap it. That pepper I put on the foil will get on the corn too. And once you get all the margarine on it and the pepper, put the corn on one end of the aluminum foil and just roll it. And it sprinkled for a little while, threatened to rain. Some dark medium clouds came over, but it didn't rain on me. We still got occasional wind gust. I just flipped the chicken for the fourth time. And so I turned the grill back on, so it will have cooked this chicken a total about 25 to 28 minutes. Like I said, it takes longer than beef, so we let it cook about 2 minutes on this side, and I'm gonna flip it over. Well, about 3 minutes on this side and 2 minutes on the other side, and it's done. The chicken's done, and I've got my corn wrapped up. See how I twisted the ends? That's how it looks. Just close her up. This will do it, my friends. Chicken and corn on the grill with the Big O. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. As always, the corn takes approximately 15 to 20 minutes to cook. It all has to do with your heat on your type of grill and the heat, the temperature inside the grill. 15 to 20 minutes on your corn. Don't cook it over 20 minutes. Chicken, about 25 minutes. Thanks for watching. Please like, comment, subscribe. As always, be happy, positive, and focused. If you ain't laughing, you ain't living. Share my videos, help my channel to continue to grow. And one question I have to ask, my friends, can you smell what the Big O's cooking? That's the real question. Big O's out.